But you're going to go to hell.
That's right.
It's best you leave me alone, because I am one of God's children. And he cried, she prayed with him, led him to the Lord, gave him $5, got him on out of college. We're not supposed to be scared of no devil in this world. Because there's a lot of fear and a lot of darkness in this world, y'all, rising up like Cain. They're trying to make you scared of the president. Where's their faith in Jesus about our president? We're supposed to honor our president. I don't care what color he is. I don't care. The office is anointed by God. We are not supposed to be talking about him on none of them channels. They wrong. They're supposed to be teaching the Christians. We're supposed to respect the government and pray for them. We're supposed to be teaching, and then they get all these ministers on there and just tear them down.
Yeah.
I said, well, y'all, what Bible y'all reading from?
That's right.
They ain't in faith. They not in faith. Or they want you to be pausing and live in the flesh with them.
Yeah.
And them Pharisee spirits,
oh, Jesus,
that always come against Jesus.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody gonna be president and do anything right. What do we want that for? God is the only one. Jesus, the only one can live perfect.
That's right.
We would spend more time praying for him, probably get more done.
Amen.
Amen. Man, doing the best he know how.
That's right.
He ain't Jesus. People want that. I had to teach them, because they ain't even sent to my church, the church I pastor, white. I said, all y'all Tea Party folks, I'm finna get y'all delivered. You need to become a Jesus party and get the tea off. I need some J in there. I said, and y'all better honor our president. We don't care who he is. Once he step in that office, then that anointing's on him. David had enough sense when Saul was trying to kill him not to touch God's anointing. And then when his son and one of his counselors sought to kill him, they couldn't kill him because he didn't sow that. You speaking bad of dignities, the Bible call you an evil person. In 2 Peter. You read. These people are central and devilish.
Yeah.
Care what church they pastor. And they want you to be a Republican. I said, no, be a Christian.
Thank you.
Stand up for Jesus. Nothing else. Because
yeah.
Jesus don't even have no First Amendment. He tell you to say what I say. Do what I do. And man, they mean, these people vicious. They vicious. And then when Bush was in, they were vicious on him. And then whoever else get in, they'll be vicious on them. They don't care. They're going to fight, man, no matter what. And we don't need to be in there. We need to be back loving and praying.
Amen.
And keeping the Spirit of Christ in our life.
Amen.
We walk by faith and not by sight. We live by hearing who Jesus is and what he did. And then we put that in our mouth. And then we act up on it and do what he told us to do. Can I give y'all a couple more verses before we close? All right, just two more. 1 John chapter 2, verse 5 and 6. And then 1 John 3, verse 22 and 23. Let me tell you something. You might not know why you came. You might not know, but the Lord love you.
Amen.
And let me tell you something. You don't even love yourself, and you have been beat up, and the devil got you sick, and you're hurting, and you're going through it in life. But I'm going to tell you something. God got some good news for you tonight.
Yes.
And listen, you putting on this old, act like you're so big and bad. You ain't all that. Listen, you know inside of you, you want the Lord to help you.
Amen.
You have been somewhere praying, asking God to help you. That's why you're in church tonight. So stop acting like that. So I can pray for you tonight. In the name of Jesus. Because I'm a preacher that loves you. I came to love you. I didn't come to condemn you. He sent me to love you. Break that mess off of you. Get you, lead you out of here well, whole. Sanctified. Filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. See, sometimes people hurt, man. Let me tell you something. They're not bad people. They need to be loved. I tell them at the church, you know, girl come in, hand on a little. I said, short. I said, we ain't even called her yet. What are y'all mad at them for? Aren't you glad she came? I'm going to teach them. Stop that. Come on, ain't you glad she came so I can get her saved? Can't eat no, clean no fish up. You ain't caught it yet. Verse 5. Look at that. Look at John. They preach the same thing. Whosoever keepeth his. What did I just start out? Yeah. Whoso keepeth Jesus' word. 1 John 2, 5. When you really keep Jesus' word, keep his word, what is going to be happening in your life? The love of God is being perfected. Y'all listen, you ain't even walking with him if this ain't happening. You ain't even walking with him if his love ain't being perfected in you. I don't know what you're doing. You're religious. Now look at the last part of verse 5. Hereby know we are in him. How you know you in him? Are you just saying that? Oh, you see his love being perfected in you every day. How you believe in how he loved you and living that love toward others. Do you see action in your life of Jesus' love, forgiveness, and kindness to people who don't deserve it? Is that how you know you in him? Is that the reason why you know? Did you know that I wouldn't have acted like this if it wasn't for him? Have you ever just went way over here and Jesus said, now come back way over here? You said, yes, sir, Lord. But where was you at first? Been to never bother them to have nothing to do with no more. His love being perfected in us. Hereby know we in him. Because the flesh trying to go one way and we yield into the spirit. That's when we know we in him. Now look at verse 6. Verse 6 is a problem. What does it say, Josh? Watch it. He that saith. All right, now what is that when he saith? Faith. Well, hold on. He that saith, what is that? It's faith. It's faith. He just said it. He abides in Jesus. What is that? That's faith. But look at the action. On himself also to walk, even as he walked. So you can say that, and it be dead. If there ain't no action of you walking even as he walked, that means he's going to have to give you this strength, this love, this power, and the wisdom to show you how to live it every day. You're going to have to trust him and do what he tell you to do, or you're not going to walk even as he walk. You see it? Y'all see it there? He that saith, I abide in him, on himself also to walk even in Jesus. Well, I just can't live right. Oh, no, you ain't believing and speaking, and you're not doing what Jesus said. That's why you can't. But you start doing that, you can. Mm-hmm. You can overcome anything. You can win a victory over anything. You can get Jesus to come through for you. But you ain't even got to borrow no loans to go to school. Yeah. Some of y'all scared. You scared. You rather borrow and then to pray. Mm. And let Jesus tell you what to do. He knows how to tell you what to do. You don't know what to do. Do you know how to get all the money for your tuition unless you have somebody in your family got plenty of money? If you don't, you don't know how to get the money. But Jesus do. You have faith in, oh, you're a person. Then have you sought him to tell you what to do to get the money? Then you don't have your faith dead. If you just say, I believe Jesus can do it, then he don't ever do it. Hey, y'all, listen. I'm trying to help y'all. Now let's go to 1 John 3, verse 22 and 23. Look at the action here. Don't you see? Faith, when you confess, you got to do what he tell you to do. John said in verse 1 John 3, 20, 22. Whatever we ask, then listen, you live. Listen, because you and I come back from the same background, a lot of stuff. And listen, you live where you protect this. See, this is what got me when I first got saved, was Jesus answering. God answered my prayers. Jesus coming through for me. Meant more to me than anything in this world. So anything he told me, I done it because I always wanted him to come through for me and answer my prayers. I'm still living that today. He got to come through for me. And I'm just sold out to do anything he say. I look every day to just please him and do whatever he tell me to do.
Yeah.
And so the key to that, look, whatever we ask, we receive of him. Now watch. I prayed. See, it didn't happen. It's a because in here. It's some action with this. Of getting all your prayers answered. Because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. You know what his commandments is? Any of y'all know? Just say, I don't know, Pastor Gaius. Because it ain't loving God with your heart, soul, and mind and strength. And it sure ain't loving your neighbors yourself. Them are laws and prophets. Jesus said in John 15, verse 12, this is my commandment, that you love one another as I love you. That commandment is two in one. Look at verse 23. This is his Jesus commandment. John is teaching you what Jesus taught them. That you believe on the name of his son Jesus Christ and love one another as he gave you commandment. Your first commandment, listen, y'all don't never forget this, is to believe, to hear what Jesus said. Believe it, speak it, and do what he tell you. So your first command is to believe how he loved you on the cross. Now here's my question. I know y'all don't know. How did Jesus love you on the cross? How? Huh? He took our sins away. Now what state were you in? Guilty. So what's your faith? Jesus did what? Say it. Took my sins away. Where? Okay, but what's your faith? He what? He took my what? He took my sins. Where? Okay, but what did he do on the cross? No. He took my sins away. Where did he take your sins away at? Okay, what did he do on the cross? Come on, you gotta say it. That's your faith. All right. What did he do on the cross? Where did he take your sins away at?
On the cross.
That's your faith. Here's your action. What I believe he did for me, I do it to you. Without that action, your faith dead. That you believe he took your sins away. It is dead if you don't take everybody else's sins away every day. And let Jesus have it. You're not going to get whatever you pray for. You're not going to get it. You're not going to get it. Unless he lied. And he didn't. So I protect this. I don't care what nobody do. All I got to do, David, is go back and go. And say, ooh, he's a robbed everybody. I said, no, I forgive him. All the Lord got to do is say, you remember all the people money you took? I said, Lord, I forgive everybody. All you got to do is look back at how he forgave you and how he loved you while you were yet a sinner. And you will let everybody go in this world. See, that's believing with action. Listen, all these years, nobody has ever done me wrong. Now tell me what I just spoke. Right. Now watch that. Why? Because I will not let my mind entertain how nobody done me but Jesus.
Amen. Right. Amen.
Ain't nobody, no race ever did me wrong. Ain't nobody ever done me wrong. And that's wrong with people. They ain't really live Jesus right yet. Because people got too much past. And they got too much history about everybody. Except Jesus. Don't shout me down. God tired of us being black and white folks. He wants some born again, Holy Ghost, new creature people. That got divine nature from heaven in us. Don't shout me down, because I'm telling the truth. We got to quit being black and white. Ain't no black Christians. Ain't no such thing in the Bible. Ain't no white Christian. Ain't no such thing in the Bible. It is God's children. We're sons of the living God. This should bother us to hear this in church. This ought to be who we are. If any man be in Christ, he's a black brother, a white brother. No, he's a new creature. And then the test is, the action to that is when you get around all your friends and how they talk and you don't stand up and say nothing. I done missed so many churches, Pastor Hill. Man, I'm talking about hundreds. Because they got to tell my dad, hey, and I was out with the blacks. And I said, well, all y'all done messed up before too. They couldn't forgive him. And then the guy around all the whites, they tearing Fred Price up. And I said, well, that's our brother though. And so I didn't get to preach with him no more. Didn't get to preach with him no more. But God kept taking care of me.
Amen.
I'm so glad my trust wasn't in that.
Because
I'm going to stand up for the truth.
Amen.
You just won't have me back no more. But when I stand for Jesus, I know one thing. He ain't going to tell me I was afraid to tell the truth. Now look what he said. We're closing. Right here, we're closing. I'll pick it back up tomorrow night. Whatever we ask, we receive of him because we keep believing how he loved us and live that love toward everybody. Your dog, your cat. Man, you can't be mad at nothing. You can't be mad at no wait, no waitress. No hope, no hotel, no food chain. You can't be mad they didn't bring your food right here. Forgive them and forget it. You got to love everybody on your job. I don't care who treats you mean, who treats you ugly. God said this is thankworthy to him when you suffer and you ain't done nothing wrong. He said this is thankworthy to him. And the Bible said, if y'all want me to really preach the Bible to you, the Bible said it pleased God when Jesus was bruised. It pleased the Father. He ain't up there sad because you're going through some persecution for him. Amen. He said, you ain't better than me. If I suffer for you, you ain't better than me. If you don't stand up for me, I ain't standing up for you, Jesus said. If you deny me before me, I'll deny you before my Father. Come on now, we got to get back to the Gospels. And then let the letters build on them. Jesus said some stuff, boy. He said, you ain't even worthy of me if you don't put me first, man. People need to hear this stuff. And John said, in verse 23, John said, this is Jesus' commandment, that you believe on the name of his son, Jesus Christ. And what is that? Tell me. That's faith. And then what's the action? Love one another as he gave you commandment. You can't have no excuse for nobody. Come on, all this love and all this kindness God done gave us. How are we going to have anything to talk up about anybody? All this kindness and love he done gave us. Now I'm ready to pray. For some of y'all, you can't sneak with the Lord. He knows, man, the secretest stuff you ever got. You know one of them charges is keep his commandments, and you know the other one to get all your prayers answered. Do those things that are pleasing in his sight. You know what's pleasing in his sight? Say, I don't know, Pastor Ted. That you keep an awareness that he's always looking and always watching you. Man, when you keep, that's one thing I done did, Pastor Hill. We used to tell you and I used to talk about this all the time. That's why our spirit's connected, because you know how to live sanctified. Well, nobody going to keep coming around, come to your church all the time, and they went right. Come on, man. He had me in more than preaching. Come on, man. See, he knew how to live. Darren them had them young girls over there, and Gail and laid there on the floor and opened the legs up. And my wife acting crazy. My wife was acting crazy. I went back up in my room, closed the door, and fell on my knees. I said, Lord Jesus, if you don't help me, I'm gone. To the Lord, I was gone. And he gave me strength. I didn't have thoughts for 2 weeks. Jesus taught me he was greater. Pastor Hill came down that day and gave me the keys to his house. Said, you can come over anytime you get ready. He saw what God was doing in my life. I said, no, I was seeing. I went and cried to the Lord to help me. You better do the same thing, because he can help you.
Amen.
I don't care what it is. Believe in Jesus with action. Run to him. Come to him. Hallelujah. Y'all move this out of the way. Now get ready to pray. Girl, listen. Don't you tell the Lord no. Look. Let me tell you something. Look. All right. Watch this here. Look at it. I'm the preacher, girl. You don't do no preacher like you know better than that. Come to church, do no preacher like that. You know better. You know your grandma and wouldn't even like that. And you say they knew you were doing a preacher like that. You gotta talk better than that. Let me tell you something. Jesus is your only hope. You have no other hope. And if you'll come up and let me pray for you, he'll heal you and touch you with some love where you ain't gotta leave here sick. Or listen to me. Well, you just made it sick and get worse. It's just that simple. Come and get it, or go and keep it. I mean, y'all young men said, Pascal, I think Jesus set me free from some stuff. Man, I look good on the outside, but the Lord knows. Y'all come up here, I'll pray for you. Jesus will set you free. You got to get up and come up here, though.
Right.
You got to get out of that chair, get out of that pride, humble yourself, and come and receive from Jesus. Come on. Come on, don't be afraid. Man, what in the world are you going to be afraid to come to Jesus for? And you got sin, you got bondages in your life, and you got troubles. You better run to Jesus. Come on now. Come on, don't play with the Lord. You know how them girls are with you. Come on. Come on. A lot of people, man, they come to church and act like they just so this and that. And they can't even run to Jesus. It's so sad. It's so sad. But I'm going to run to him. Hey, man, where'd you come from? What's wrong with you? Can I tell you what's wrong with you? You don't know how to believe in Jesus. We're going to teach you and help you. What's where you come from? Okay, what do you need then? From hearing the message tonight, what do you need? You need a word from Jesus. And in his word is strength. If you could just hear him tell you in his word that I'll be with you. Then when it gets hard, you say, Jesus, help me, because you believe he really with you. Where you up here, brother? Where you need to live in front? It's my old girl. I'm glad you came. You ain't gonna never smoke no more the rest of your life. Where you up here, brother? He's going to set you free. Don't break that off. You know how you're going to do it. You're going to give your life to him tonight, and you ain't never done it. And I'll be honest with you. You've been in church, right? In church. Man, I decide. We're going to give you that. tickets at WCD, and they'll take that out.
Oh, very, very, addictions.
Okay.
Addictions.
It's my heart, you know? No, but Jesus, though, he'll fix it. Okay, good. When I lay hands on you, power God, Lord, and you make it whole. I want y'all to lift your hands up.
Jesus.
We're going to surrender that. Have you ever gave your whole life to Jesus? Your whole life? Who'd you give it to? Well, where he at? See, watch. He's in your heart. What do you call that? Listen to this. What do you call that? Faith. But him coming out of your heart and working in your situations, that ain't happening. So we need some action with this faith. You see what I'm saying? So that he can work in your life. I want y'all to lift your hands up and say, Lord Jesus,
I thank you
for your love.
What you did on the cross.
God sent you from heaven.
The one with no sin.
I confess with my mouth.
Jesus Christ, my Lord.
I believe.
On the third day,
God's mighty power
raised Jesus from the dead.
I surrender tonight.
I
repent
of
doubt and unbelief.
I turn
to the blood of Jesus.
And I receive
deliverance,
peace,
wisdom.
Take that, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Say, Lord Jesus, I belong to you now.
I repent of my sins.
I turn from them.
And I surrender my life to you.
Lord, let your glory come on here.
Your glory.
Soboko.
Rasikirita.
Manga zanande.
Burn that stuff up, Lord.
Show him how great you are.
In the name of Jesus.
And let that fire get in him, Lord.
That fire of the living God.
And Lord, I break those commando devils to lose his life.
In Jesus' name.
Lord, he'll never be the same.
Jesus.
I pray the fear of God will be in him. Well, he won't be to live like he used to. In Jesus' name.
Lord, thank you.
And Lord, as she hears the word,
they will come to you.
Yeah, you won't never be the same. In the name of Jesus.
Be blessed, Jesus.
By the authority of Jesus, I curse that pain. And I command you that your knees be whole and function normal according to the word of God.
And Lord Jesus, I'm not doubting my heart.
But believe,
don't think.
Which I say
is
here.
Father,
thank you for your anointing and your glory and your power on this young man, and he'll never be the same.
I pray you'll give him clarity and wisdom,
and Lord, give him understanding how to operate in the authority of the name of Jesus,
where he can resist devils.
Put him on the run
in the name.
In the name.
Understand me.
I give you all the praise.
I give you all the honor.
In the name.
In the name.
Take that anointing. Receive it now. It's yours.
It's yours.
It's yours.
It's yours.
Lord, burn up that junk in
us
so we can serve the living God.
Clean his conscience.
Cleanse
his conscience.
I tell the Lord Jesus, listen, all that's wrong with you is you won't do what he said.
Look at it. You ain't doing what he said.
And you got somebody in your life that ain't supposed to be there.
Stop it.
Ooh,
and walk with the Lord like he tells you.
Y'all lift your hands and stand, thank the Lord. You won't ever be the same. You won't ever be the same. And you get your couple of series back there. Listen to me. That one a day or one every 2 days. Get your schedule where you stay on it. That thou has to leave.
But now be honest. Now where's that at now?
How you know it's gone?
Yeah.
Wait, well, say that again.
How you know the Lord saved you?
Give my mic.
How you know the Lord saved you?
Just
because I felt his spirit.
Run past you.
Did y'all hear that?
Look at y'all.
So what you used to do, you said you would never do it again.
Yes.
Why?
Because God saved you with his word.
And what ran through you while you was up here?
His Holy Spirit.
What did it do?
He just ran right past me.
So it went right in. They couldn't make that up. Now go live it. Be real, be honest. That's one of the greatest things when I got saved. I could be honest now. I was so happy to be honest, Pastor Hill, I didn't know what to do.
Glory.
I had never been honest. I always had a lie cover up and sin. Ever since I was a little child. We stole all the time. So we always had a lie. And the man said, "What you got in your pocket?" I said, "Nothing." You know, just always. Just grew up a little child, man.
Hallelujah.
And then I got saved. I was so happy. I didn't have to lie no more.
Thank you.
And I got people would give me too much money in the bank. I'd go in the car and cry and thank the Lord that he had saved me and changed me. And I go back and give them the money back. And jeweler gave me $1,300 too much. And I went out to the car and cried and gave that money back. And they treated me real nice after that. And then I even left Kroger's. And they forgot to charge. And I just put my groceries in the car. And the Lord said, "You didn't pay for paper towels." Mm-hmm. They was on the bottom. I said, "Yeah, I did, Lord. He said, "No, you ain't paying for them. Look on." I looked over and see it wasn't on there. He said, "Take them back." I said, "Well, I'll do it tomorrow." Boy, I lost all my peace. I turned around, went and took that back, and went and paid for them. Come on now. I'm talking about holiness, Christianity. God sees that stuff.
Amen.
Amen. He sees that stuff. Amen.
Amen.
You got to do what's right. Girl, give me your hand. Give me your hand. I'm going to pray for you if you give me your hand. I'm going to pray for you if you give me your hand. It's your last chance. Give me your hand. I'm going to probably ask God to bless you and have mercy on you and bless your children. I'm going to ask God to bless your children. If you'll give me your hand, I'm going to ask God to bless them children of yours and protect them here today from them hooligans out there. Give me your hand so the bullets won't come to him. And give me your hand so I can pray for your children. I'm going to pray for them little ones of yours. Holding your hand. Come on now. I'm praying for your children now. I'm praying for your children that they don't get shot. Okay. I'm praying for them now. Hold my hand. Father, in Jesus' name. No, y'all come on and pray the Holy Ghost. I just pray, Lord, that you'll bless these children. You'll protect them. You'll watch over them, Lord. And Father, she just, that was her step of faith. To reach a hand out. I bind those devils off of her that she'll have a choice. That they'll not hinder her choice to come to Jesus. And I pray you'll bless her family and have mercy on them, Lord. Love and kindness on them. And that you'll protect those children from bullets and from any kind of hurt or harm. Especially that girl. In Jesus' name. Amen. And I pray for you all too. And I pray for you. Don't you let no man hurt you. You tell somebody if some man is doing something wrong to you. You understand me? Father, in Jesus' name, I just pray your blessings upon these children. You're protecting and keeping them from the evil one in this world. In Jesus' name. Lord, let your love be shown in their lives. Who Jesus is and what Jesus did. Jesus' name. Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all bring it back tomorrow. Amen. I need another shot at that. Amen. Amen. Y'all be seated. Bless you. You. Okay. Hey, y'all, let's go ahead and take a love offering up to help me in the ministry.